The world's oceans are the biggest source of food for the whole planet. Almost 35% of the world's population gets most of their protein from ocean animals. It seems unlikely that this vast resource could ever run out of the creatures we catch to feed ourselves. But although seafood markets around the world appear to be full, they hide a crisis: overfishing. Overfishing occurs when fishermen catch more animals than the oceans can sustain. And it changes the environment in other ways, too. In Jamaica, fishermen laid down a huge net around the bay. This traditional method of fishing used to feed a whole village. But now, because of overfishing, there are fewer fish, and those remaining are smaller.
When I came here about 15 years ago, I used to see fish all around the quay. Fish, big parrot, big snappers, big groupers.
But not anymore. And having only small fish in the oceans causes big problems. Small fish produce fewer eggs. That makes it hard for fish populations to grow. And small fish are more likely to have small offspring. So fish size cannot increase either. Overfishing has also changed the kinds of fish fishermen catch. These aren't the choice fish they used to take to market. Instead, they're the little fish the big fish used to eat. All in all, overfishing adds up to one sad fact. The world's oceans can't sustain the current level of fishing. But we still need to fish.
But we have to fish, because that's what we live from, fishing. And if there's no fish, no food on our table.
Fortunately, something can be done about the ocean's downward spiral. In many places across the world, countries and communities are setting up marine reserves. In a no-take reserve, like this one in Jamaica's Pedro Bank, no fishing is permitted for a number of years. This allows adult fish and other creatures to reproduce in greater numbers. Small fish grow to adulthood and become big fish. Bigger fish and other animals spill over into the ocean around the reserve, where catching them is permitted. And that's good for fishermen. Marine reserves are big projects that yield impressive results for fisheries. But there are steps everyone can take to help protect the oceans. Catch only what you need, but no more. Follow local fishing rules. Never catch creatures during their breeding seasons. Know your seafood. Understand which animals are sustainable and where they came from. Give creatures a chance to breed. Choose larger ones. Don't destroy animal habitats like coral reefs, seagrass beds, and mangroves. And don't use destructive fishing gear. Overfishing has taken a heavy toll on all the animals we catch to eat. Fish and other ocean populations can recover and feed future generations. But only if we take steps now to look after our planet's greatest shared resource.